When the Trump administration outlined federal guidelines back in March for work considered essential during the COVID-19 pandemic, it included specific language for new and existing oil pipeline construction projects. Within days, Canadian-owned TC Energy Corporation announced it had secured more than $1 billion to continue with construction of the 1,200-mile Keystone XL pipeline. The project, which was halted in 2015 by the Obama administration amid growing public outcry, was reissued permits in the early days of the Trump administration, with the stipulation that American steel be used in the work. Now, as thousands of oil workers enter states along the construction route in the midst of the pandemic, legal challenges are mounting amid health concerns. NewsHour Weekend's Ivette Feliciano has more.
On March 31st, with stay-at-home orders still in place in Nebraska, South Dakota, and Montana due to the COVID-19 pandemic, oil and gas company TC Energy Corporation announced plans to proceed with construction of the Keystone XL pipeline.
I found that incredible that they think that they could move ahead with this thing.
The prospect of hundreds of out-of-state oil workers flooding his state worries 68-year-old farmer Art Tandrup. He grows corn and soy in northeast Nebraska, about 900 feet from the proposed pipeline route. Tandrup is concerned that local hospitals aren't equipped to handle a potential COVID-19 outbreak pipeline workers might bring into the community.
You know, in Nebraska, we have the issues with the meatpacking plants where our numbers are skyrocketing right now. And these plants are close to the route in some cases. As a matter of fact, a couple of them are just a few miles from the route. So as these workers mingle in these communities, there's a greater chance of spreading.
66-year-old Jeannie Crumley's family has run a farm and cattle ranch in Holt County, Nebraska for 5 generations.
What was your reaction when you learned that TC Energy would be continuing with pipeline construction in the midst of this pandemic?
Oh, it's their way of doing business. We've been dealing with them for 12 years. If our children can't go to school, if our children can't swing on the swings in the park, then in the midst of all of that, then a foreign company can send whoever they want on the land we pay taxes on. How can they do all the things that we don't when we're the landowners and we're the community members?
Shortly after announcing the renewed construction plans, Keystone XL's president posted this message on TC Energy's website regarding the threat of COVID-19.
We've already made adjustments to some of our work plans in consideration of COVID-19, and we'll continue to collaborate with our suppliers and contractors to further enhance safety measures. Construction will only take place after giving every consideration for the health and safety of our people and their families, and for those in the surrounding communities.
The company says those adjustments include enhanced screening measures, minimizing travel in and out of work sites to essential personnel, and sanitizing transport vehicles. But Art Tandrup claims that isn't what's happening on site.
Some of our friends that have visited the pipe yards this last weekend, well, they've shown pictures. Nobody's wearing a mask. It's just business as usual, so to speak.
TC Energy did not respond to PBS NewsHour Weekend's request for an interview. The renewed construction plans sparked several legal actions by a coalition of environmentalists and indigenous rights advocates last month. They're just the latest lawsuits and ongoing legal challenges against President Trump's 2019 decision to reapprove the KXL pipeline without conducting environmental reviews that federal courts have previously ordered.
We already killed this pipeline project.
Dallas Goldtooth is a ground campaign organizer with the Indigenous Environmental Network, which filed a joint lawsuit against the Trump administration on April 5th.
President Obama declared it was not in the interest of the United States public. It went against the climate test because his administration understood that by approving this project, that it's going to greatly contribute to climate change and global greenhouse gas emissions. And what President Trump did is he went and revived it. That's why we're calling the Keystone XL pipeline the zombie pipeline. We keep stopping and shutting it down, and it keeps coming back to life.
That lawsuit awaits a decision. On April 15th, in response to a separate lawsuit, a U.S. District Court judge temporarily blocks construction of the KXL pipeline through waterways until the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers conducts studies complying with the Endangered Species Act. Jane Klebb is the founder of Bold Nebraska, a land and water protection organization that is part of that lawsuit.
So far, Judge Morris has agreed with many of the arguments that we are making, and he issued an order telling the Army Corps of Engineers they can't just do a blanket kind of permit for every water crossing, that they have to do studies on every single water crossing, which they never have done.
But construction continues in areas where the pipeline won't cross water, all in the midst of the coronavirus pandemic. On April 16th, two tribal communities in Montana and South Dakota requested an injunction to stop construction in light of the pandemic, arguing the influx of thousands of transient out-of-state construction workers poses irreparable health risks to the tribes. That injunction request awaits a decision. In the meantime, Indigenous rights activists in Montana are protesting near the construction site.
We prayed today and had a little ceremony to pray against the KXL that's going to affect the people.
This month, Nebraska, South Dakota, and Montana relaxed some quarantine restrictions on non-essential businesses and lifted stay-at-home orders. Farmer Art Tandrup in Nebraska, who is also part of the Ponca Indigenous tribe there, says that's all the more reason out-of-state oil workers should not enter his community.
It's in their off time that we really have some concerns. You know, where do they eat? Where do they stay? What are they bringing with them? And right now, with the COVID going on, is not a good time to move into Nebraska, South Dakota, or Montana. Not a good time at all.